Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to start the $2 6 max challenge on GG Poker and Natural8. I'm actually going to play Natural8 today. Sometimes I play GG Poker, sometimes Natural8. They are the same player pools, essentially. I'm not sure if there are any sort of fundamental differences in games played, but I know it's the same player pool. So today I'm on Natural8. So you can see there the target's $200, profit is zero because we haven't played any games yet. Just to show you, yesterday I played some $5 games on Natural8. And it's, today is actually the 28th where I am, 28th of March. And when I downloaded my hands from PokerCraft and put them into Holdem Manager yesterday on the 27th, it was coming out with the date was the 28th. I'm not really quite sure why that is. I haven't really had time to investigate it. Maybe there's my computer times are okay. Maybe there's something wrong with the Holdem Manager times. I don't know. But there you go. So that these were yesterday. And then we had a little session. I think we played four tables. We played about just over 700 hands. So this is the net profit. That was $40, 8 buy-ins on the $5 game. So that's... We're going to probably start our $5 six-match challenge on Natural8 tomorrow. So this kind of just gets added to the normal bankroll overall. But the proper the $5 challenge will start tomorrow. Now, what I'm going to do, what I have been doing for the other challenges, is that I have been putting... I've been showing you my Holdem Manager graph regularly throughout the session. It's not going to be possible for me to do that when I'm on GG or Natural8. I will show you the PokerCraft graph. Sorry, my throat's a bit sore, I think. And so there it is for today. $2 games. We're just about to start. And there's no data there yet, so nothing on that. So I'll update this as we go along and try to show you if I can. And I'll either put the Holdem Manager update at the end of this video or at the beginning of the next video. It probably easier for me to do it at the beginning of the next video. The figures on PokerCraft and Holdem Manager are different. Some of you who use both may know this already. PokerCraft gives you the gross figure, and that doesn't tell you. It doesn't deduct the rake. So sometimes you look like you're doing really well, and it actually turns out you're not doing so well as you think. But with the Holdem Manager, you can get the green line's the net figure. That's what you've actually won, and you can actually see what rake you've paid. I don't think you can see the rake with PokerCraft. So, for whatever reason. Okay, so let's get some tables open. So I think that's what we want to do. We're playing $2 6 max. I think I'll play three tables. I think that's about right. I think two tables when I'm playing Zoom or Russian Cash, and three tables when I'm playing 6 max slow, and then if I'm playing 9 max on PokerStars, maybe 4 tables. Okay, so let's get rid of this picture here. Okay. Yeah. There you go. So there's one table. We need to open some more. That's two. And... just us on at the moment. Hopefully they'll fill up fairly quickly, tend to do. And there's three. So we are away. I will try to zoom in as much as I can. Yeah. With these, so. With all that money there, I'm just gonna go with the Jack 10. Lose, but we get a good shot. I mean, we should really fold, but with all those chips to play for, a queen would be nice. I'm gonna fold now. I haven't played $2 on here for quite some time, and so I don't really know these players. I mean, I've got this one label here in the top left, but the rest are pretty much unlabeled, so unlabeled, unknown. We'll see. So we should be able to zoom in. Easiest, top left, top right, bottom left, overall. So I'll just have to try to remember to do that. So hopefully you've been enjoying the little mini challenges. It seems it kind of reflects a little bit the way that I play. Sometimes I like to play 9 max, sometimes 6 max, sometimes zoom. And so rather than just sort of, you know, doing like a linear approach, and which I suppose would be the fairly normal way to do things, I thought I'd do these little mini challenges to, you know, I think it gives me an opportunity to do quite a bit of content and quite a bit of an assessment at each level and each site, and should take me quite some time. Call with the ace four. Yeah, so that session yesterday, $5. I think we just had a lot of luck. It was one of those sessions that just everything, we were hitting everything. People were calling all ins fairly loosely, so I think we kind of doubled up and a couple of times, and suddenly we were in great shape. Nothing with the 9 jack at the top. Oops, I was a bit slow with the ace, the i7 now. Obviously we have the draw here. I could have re-raised this, I think if it was 2 people I possibly would have re-raised. 3 players. That. Oh. Jack 9's dead. I could have a bluff at it. That would be fairly reckless at this stage. talking to. Gonna check. Cool. Yeah, now I'm going to favor bet. Hopefully he hasn't got a straight 2, 3, 4, 5. 4, 5 obviously gets there. And we've got the boat. Will he call a bet? Maybe. Oh, whoa, what should we do? Fault? Okay, I'll just take a screenshot of that. You might see a bit of a flat. Oh, I missed it because I make a note of that on a piece of paper. I'd like to maybe put that one as a short. You can see I'm doing little all-in shorts. Let's see my little piece of paper. I'll zoom out. Call one with the 5-3. Give it up. Okay, well, we doubled up already. Let's see if we can get that on to PokerCraft. See how that looks. Oops, I was looking at PokerCraft, not at the screen there, so. Don't seem to give you much time, these dude, don't they? Can give us a little bit more time. Okay, so there's a PokerCraft graph. From 20 odd hands, $1.50. Gross. I'm trying to make that a bit bigger actually. See. There you go. Okay, so I'll try to update that as we go along, and then that'll be the figure that I use on the thumbnail, and then at the beginning of the next video I'll look in between that, and now I'll upload that onto Holdem Manager. Just save me doing it at the end of this video, because I'm going to play now for about an hour or so just to get this challenge underway, and then I've been staked for some tournament or two on Natural8, a $15 tournament, sold 70%, and I don't really intend to play tournaments unless I kind of sell a lot of it. And then an $8 tournament. Oh, I'm not sure about that one. Just a little $20 in tournaments, and then I just play some cash games as well. I'll see how it goes. The tournaments are not really going to cost me any money. Do we have the best hand there? I think so. Great with the 8-4. That's a bonus. The ace king. I'm gonna bet small because we do have a bit of half pot because there are draws on there. I mean, checking is an option, but I think we do need a little bit of protection there. Okay, so if he's got a three, he's got a straight. He certainly does have the threes. I'm gonna continue betting. I'm just gonna check in case he's trapping with a three. 8-7. I'm lost. Fine. I'm just gonna check in case he's trapping with a three. I overthought that one. Give them too much credit. Okay. As you can see, it's tough. Oh my god. Oh dear. Okay, we've hit the ace with the ace queen. I'm just gonna call it. Ace 10, nice. Oh, it's a bit aggressive, isn't it? Ace 10. I had a good shot, I suppose. Oh, I'll zoom out again. Just need to remember to do that. A bit small with the ace jack. We could have the best hand with the 3-2. Yes, looks like it. To rebet the tens. About the ace king. I'm gonna fold it a short stack and 86%. I could be messing about, but. Annoying. be patient and wait our time. Don't make a mistake playing like that. Hold the fives. Trips on the right. Half pot. In a bed up there. I mean, there could be a straight already there, but obviously we do have the queen. Oh, annoying card. Another annoying card. Okay. He wanted our cards. Oh yeah. Miss that hand on the right. I can't focus. Well, I don't think there was anything there anyway. See if we can have a quick look at Poker Craft. After this ace king hand, I think. All bet. Hold the 10-8. Annoying. Come on, heart. Heart. Ace. Wonderful. What happens if you go crazy with 10-10 then? Fold. Not that I'm complaining. All fives got there with the ace queen, we call one. Okay, I'll try and look at Poker Craft now. Try, if I get a chance. All this craziness going on. Okay, here we go. The graph. $4, 100 hands, 120 hands, I think. $4, 3 buy-ins. $50 big blinds, 100, I think. Something like that, I don't know. We've had a bit of luck. That's the gross figure. It'll be great to take off that. Oh, we have a little gamble with the ace three. I did say this guy was going to lose his stack soon. Just I didn't take it. Oh well, we'll take the last few chips. Maybe. We raise the ace 10. I'm gonna 3-bet, 4-bet the king queen suited. Didn't realize I had a big stack there. I mean, I did before a 4-bet, but didn't realize I had that. Started the game. A bit of half pot. Thank you. Alright, we got top pair. Good shot. We have the flush, I'm gonna check. Alright, call the ace 10. I'm gonna call here in case he's messing about. Okay, I'm not folding. I mean, we get beat by lots of things. Plus, ace king. Jack, jack, 10-10. And I just think it's going to be unlucky for us. We don't have the best hand. But there we go. Okay, king, queen. Didn't mention that one. Another one that we're beat by. Okay. Not a bad play. Really. But certainly foldable. Yeah, we didn't beat the flush, we didn't beat the straight. Oh, that's just a blunder, wasn't it? Put that down to being crap. Okay, let's update the poker craft. Took a hit there with the stack that we lost. I mean, it was aggressive with the straight, wasn't it? I mean, he's certainly was beaten by a flush, so we know that much. Okay, there's the poker craft now. Plus $2, 150 hands, something like that. Okay. Well, we got another top pair queen with a flush on the board. Great. I'm going to bet into that. That's good enough. We stay on this table, we've got queens. We get hit with an ace. I'll put a small bet in. Now we've got a set. A bet up. Oh. Does he have King 10? Would he have called a bet with King 10 on the flop? Don't think so. I'm gonna fold the ace jack to the overbet. Just it's a weak fold, but it's certainly very continuable and should be continued probably, but I don't have anything ace high. Pair of aces. Little bit of protection from the draw, half pot. So it doesn't have set. I'm just going all in with the ace. Ah. You're kidding me, man. You're kidding me. You're kidding me. Come on, heart. Club. Wow. I hurt. Well, that's two stacks gone in 10 minutes. Probably back down to zero now. Depressing. Started off well. And then disaster struck. Okay, it's early days in this challenge. Maybe I'm being a bit aggressive with those couple of hands, but how annoying. Thank you. Don't have 10 queen. With the king jack. 10 queen, is it? You can't be doing this to me again. Okay. I'll fold the ace 5 here. A small bit of the queens. I'm just gonna put the Ace King in, yeah, it doesn't have a big stack. Nine-two. Makes sense. You know there's gonna be a nine or a two on the flop. Oh, here we, it looks like we've got one. The next one, 9-2. Miracle. Top pair with the queen, we'll call that. About a half pot, hopefully take it down. Bet the ace queen. Okay, here's the poker craft. Plus $1 or up, down, back up a little bit. Early days yet though. Probably on zero if you considered a rake. But you know, I haven't made two mistakes. Well, probably a lot more than two mistakes, but two big mistakes that cost us. Maybe. Let's zoom out again. Bet the king jack suited. Keep up a bit of aggression. Get top pair. Gonna fire one in to protect the jacks. Okay, obviously we're beaten by ace, ace, king, king, queen, queen. Then go. Big, just to fight against ace, king, ace, queen. I'm gonna 4-bet the ace jack to try and take it down free. Maybe should have been a bit bigger. Get out of the way now. Six, nine, six. I love it. Ace jack would have won it. Oh well. I think we made the right decision. Let's have a look at the poker craft. Okay, back up to $3 or 250 hands, something like that. So up, down, up, sort of thing. As you can see for yourself. So we come back a little bit from the disasters. I'm gonna flat the fives with all the money out there. I'm gonna free bet the nines. We hit the set with the fives. I'm gonna flat the king nine and check the fives. Check the nine. Ooh. Interesting hand with the king nine. Okay, I'm gonna overbet with the fives. might have the best hand dials. Raise it up with the King 9. Put it up in case somebody's going to go with a set. Ah. You're joking me. Unreal. Unreal, man. Unreal. Well done, him. Okay. Oh, we got a set on the bottom left. Okay, well, that was a hand, wasn't it? I didn't swear. Is the PokerCraft $2 at 250, 260 hands. Zoom out a little bit. Rebet the queen. I'm a free bet the king 10. I'm gonna put a stop to these limps a little bit, but I think that's going to have much of an impact. These stations. Pot. Oh. Okay, I'm stuck. What is it? How much help do they need to get? Seriously. 64%. I mean, there certainly was a call there. But you know, we've got an open end. Oh, we got the straight here. Okay. That is such TPO, is it? There must be at some point where you lead. Jack at the bottom. That. 7. I'm just gonna flat the ace queen. No joy there. With the nines, I think now. I'm betting in with the draw and the middle pair. Wonderful. Have a bluff at it. Wonderful. Of course you do. I just shoved the queens. Hold one more. Very good. Okay, I'm going to pause it there. So let's sit out. And so we've got the $2 challenge started. Let's just see what the poker craft looks like. Like I said, this is the poker craft. It's $2.50. And okay. I'll just put $2 on the thumbnail. And it might be about that with the rake taken off, and I will load those hands onto my Holdem Manager, and the next time we do the $2 challenge, we'll be up to date with that. So tomorrow probably we'll start the $5 challenge. We did well yesterday with $5 plus 8 buy-ins. Not so well today, made a few mistakes today. I'm a little bit tired. I've got to play a tournament now. I'm just going to have a bit of a break, a bit of a coffee. And who knows. I'll wake up a little bit, I'm sure. And I'll probably play some cash games whilst I'm playing my tournament. And I'm not sure what level that will be yet. See how I feel. Okay, thank you for watching. I'll load this up shortly. Have a great day.